गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन न्यू सेशन 2020-21 एंड इन न्यू क्लास क्लास 11th. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, देयर आर टू बुक्स प्रिस्क्राइब्ड इन योर सिलेबस. द नेम ऑफ फर्स्ट बुक इज हॉर्नबिल एंड द सेकेंड बुक इज स्नैपशॉट. Dear students, today I am going to start the first lesson of your Hornbill book, and the name of lesson is The Portrait of a Lady, written by one of the renowned Indian writers, Mr. Khushwant Singh. Mr. Khushwant Singh was born in Punjab and was educated in Modern School, New Delhi, St. Stephen's College, and graduated from Government College, Lahore. He earned LLB degree also from King's College, London, and he worked as a lawyer, as a journalist, as a diplomat, as a writer, and as a politician. Mr. Khushwant Singh is a famous personality of our country and a well-known writer. This lesson he has written about his grandmother, and the title of the lesson is The Portrait of a Lady. It means this lesson is description of a lady who was grandmother of Mr. Khushwant Singh. Mr. Khushwant Singh was very much closed and attached to her grandmother, because he got opportunity to spend much time with her, with his grandmother. Or this particular lesson, The Portrait of Lady, he has given, he has written about his grandmother. He draws a lifelike portrait. His grandmother was very old. Her face was wrinkled, her hair was white. It was hard to believe that once she had been young and pretty. His grandfather's picture hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room, or he wore a big turban. His clothes were loose. He looked at least 100 years old. It was hard to believe that the man who was in the photo, he had once a wife or children. Here, writer Khushwant Singh's grandmother was a very religious lady. She was fat and slightly bent. She couldn't walk straight. She hobbled about the house, or his grandmother had to keep one hand on her waist to maintain the balance, to manage the balance. In the other side, on the other hand, she held a rosary. As I have told you that his grandmother was a religious lady, so she used to held a rosary, and she was always telling the beads. Her lips constantly moved in prayer. She put on white clothes. She used to wear white clothes. His grandmother was a religious lady. Her silver locks, her silver hairs scattered over her yellowish face. She looked like a snowy mountain in winter. She looked like a snowy mountain in winter. She was a picture of peace, contentment, and she was very old. Perhaps she could not have looked older. She looked the same for the last 20 years. Writer observed that there was no change in the appearance of his grandmother. A writer spent his childhood days with his grandmother. Most of the time he was living with his grandmother from morning to late night. His grandmother was his guide, his carer, his mentor, his teacher, everything. Khushwant Singh and his grandmother were good friends. As Mr. Khushwant Singh spent most of the time with his grandmother, so he came close to him. He was highly impressed by the personality of his grandmother, or due to that he became friend of his grandmother. When Khushwant Singh was a small child, his parents, his father and mother, they went to city. They were living there, or here in the village, Mr. Khushwant Singh was living with his grandmother. His parents left him with her in the village. His grandmother, as a good carer, as a responsible human being, as a good grandmother, she took good care of him. She used to wake up Mr. Khushwant Singh in the morning. She got him ready for the school. She said her morning prayer loudly. She used to recite the prayers loudly so that Mr. Khushwant Singh would learn it by heart. But Mr. Khushwant Singh has written in his book, he liked her voice, but he never took pain to learn and memorize the prayers recited by his grandmother. Or after that, she would fetch his wooden slate on which he was writing. She had already washed it and plastered it with yellow chalk. She would take an earthening pot and reed pen. She would tie them in a bundle and hand it to Mr. Khushwant Singh. After that, she would give him a thick stale chapatis with little butter and sugar spread on it. This was the breakfast of Mr. Khushwant Singh every morning. After breakfast, both grandson and grandmother, they start their journey. They used to start their journey for the school, or she carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. His grandmother always went to school with him, or the school was attached to the temple. The priest was the teacher, और द प्रीस्ट टॉट द चिल्ड्रन अल्फाबेट्स एंड मॉर्निंग प्रेयर एंड रिलीजियस प्रेयर्स द चिल्ड्रंस ऑफ लोकेलिटी ऑफ हिज विलेज इंक्लूडिंग मिस्टर खुशवंत सिंह. दे सेट इन रोज ऑफ द बरांडा ऑफ द टेम्पल. दे वुड सिंग द अल्फाबेट्स आर प्रेयर्स इन कोरस इन अ लाउड वॉयस. द ग्रैंड मदर सेट इन साइड द टेम्पल वेन मिस्टर खुशवंत सिंह वॉज स्टडिंग इन बरांडा अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ दैट प्रीस्ट. एट दैट टाइम हिज ग्रैंड मदर वॉज सिटिंग इन साइड द टेम्पल एंड सी वॉज बिजी इन प्रेयर. सी वुड रीड होली बुक्स और देन after the completion of prayer and after the completion of the studies, both Mr. Khushwant Singh and his grandmother, they would walk home together. The village dogs would gather at the temple door every day because the grandmother used to carry and bring some chapati, stale chapatis for the dogs. And she used to throw chapatis to the dogs at the gate, temple gate. The dogs would growl and fight with each other for the chapatis thrown by grandmother. This was the routine of Khushwant Singh and his grandmother every day. Mr. Khushwant Singh spent his childhood days with his grandmother and he was very much attached. After some years, when his parents, Khushwant Singh's parents, were well settled in the city, they came in position to call Khushwant Singh and his grandmother to city. So they called both Khushwant Singh and his grandmother to the city. It was the turning point. Writer was very close to his grandmother in village and very much attached to her. But when both were called by Khushwant Singh's parents in the city, this was the turning point in their friendship. Because here the writer was getting less time to talk with his grandmother. Grandmother was also getting less time to talk with the writer, Khushwant Singh. They shared the same room, but grandmother no longer went to school with him. Because here in the city, he got admission in new school, or here the grandmother was not getting opportunity to go to school with him. The narrator used to go to an English school in a motor bus. There were no dogs in the streets. There in the village, they were followed by the dogs. But here in the city, there were no dogs to follow the writer's grandmother. So grandmother took to feeding the sparrows. There she was feeding chapatis and throwing chapatis and giving chapatis to the village dogs. Or here she was feeding the sparrows. Many years passed. Years rolled by. Both grandmother and Khushwant Singh saw less of each other. Sometimes she would ask him what the teacher had taught him. Grandmother used to inquire about his studies. She did not believe in the things that the writer was studying at English medium school. She was very much unhappy. She did not like English and science. She felt sad. as there was no teaching about God and scriptures at the school. The narrator one day told his grandmother that the teacher was teaching them music also. She was very much disturbed because she thought that music is not good for him. She thought that music was quite indecent. For her, in her opinion, it was good only for the prostitutes and beggars because they used to sing and they used to dance. But the good people, reputed people, decent people, they should not learn music and they should not practice music. It was not meant for gentle folk. After completing his education, school education, college education, writer finally went to university. Or when writer got admission in university, he was given a room of his own, separate room. So the common link of friendship was broken. When writer was in school, in English medium school, up to class 12th, so grandmother was getting opportunity, chance to talk and share her views and to know about the studies of Mr. Khushwant Singh. But when he got admission in university, so the common link of friendship was snapped. The grandmother accepted her loneliness quietly. She knew, she understood the position. She was always busy with the spinning wheel and reciting the prayers. She rarely talked to anyone. In the afternoon, she relaxed for some time. Or she would feed the sparrows because it was her daily routine. Hundreds of the sparrows came there. They created a lot of noise. Some came and sat on her legs. Others would sit on her shoulders. And some would sit even on her head. But she smiled. She never frightened them away. Feeding the sparrows was the happiest half hour of the day for her. That 30 minutes was the happiest moment of her day. After completing, this was the routine of Dadiji, our grandmother of Khushwant Singh. Dear children, after completing his university education, narrator Khushwant Singh decided to go abroad for higher studies. He got opportunity to go abroad to study there, or he was to remain away for 5 years. Grandmother was very old. She could die any moment. The narrator, Mr. Khushwant Singh, was worried, but the grandmother was not upset. When writer was going abroad, she was not upset. She showed no emotions. She came to the railway station to see him off. Her lips moved in prayer at that time. Her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers were busy in telling the beads of her rosary. At last, she kissed the writer's forehead silently. Writer Mr. Khushwant Singh thought that it was the last sign of physical contact between his grandmother and him. But fortunately, when narrator Khushwant Singh returned home after 5 years after completing his studies from abroad, His grandmother met him at the station. She welcomed the writer. She did not look a day older. She did not speak anything. She held him in her arm. She went on reciting her prayer. In the afternoon, the writer observed, she fed the sparrows as usual as she was feeding them every afternoon. In the evening, the writer observed some change in the nature of grandmother because she did not pray at that evening. She collected the women of neighborhood or she got an old drum. She continued thumping. She was very happy and she was very much excited. She started singing. She sang Homecoming of the Warriors. She welcomed the writer as a warrior who came after many years completing his duties. Writer and his family member, they try to persuade her to stop. She might overstrain herself. It was the first time writer has mentioned it was the first time for that she had forgotten to pray. Otherwise, she used to continuously pray. The next morning, the writer's grandmother, she fell ill. She had a mild fever. Writer's grandmother told them that her end was near. It was not a normal fever, it was the fever of death. She realized that she had forgotten to pray. She didn't want to talk to anybody at the last moment of her life. She was not in mood to waste her time. She ignored their request and she continued her prayer. She was praying and telling the beads. Then suddenly her lips stopped moving. The rosary fell down from her lifeless fingers. Her face looked aloys but peaceful. And now the grandmother was no more. She was dead. Finally, she was laid on the ground. She was covered with shroud. All other arrangements for her funeral were made. It was the evening time. The sun was setting. They brought the wooden stretcher. They stopped halfway in the courtyard. Thousands of the sparrows at that evening came and sat near the dead body, but they did not create any noise at that day. They were also sad. Everyone felt sorry for the birds. The narrator's mother's heart melted. She brought some bread. She broke into the little crumbs. She threw those pieces of bread to the sparrows, but the birds took no notice of them. And then she carried, the writer and his family member, they carried her dead body outside for the funeral, for cremation. The sparrows flew away quietly. At that evening, they did not create any noise. They were not chirping. The crumbs of the bread, the pieces of bread still remained lying there in the courtyard. Dear students, evidently the sparrows had come to show their respect, to mourn the death of grandmother. This is all about this lesson. I have told you, and line by line, I will tell you tomorrow.